Hey everybody, welcome back to Infinite Warfare. It's been a couple of weeks since we last uploaded in the Road to 30 series. I wanted to talk about some of the things that I've accomplished since that last episode. Of course, last time we ended up getting Black Sky on the Venom X, which I don't think was an easy task at all considering the players that we currently have available in this game. You either have, the scale is really weird. You have really tryhard players that are going for nukes every single lobby. It doesn't even matter if you're playing team deathmatch or domination, they're going for nukes. And then you have people who are just getting this game for the first time, level 10, level 6, level 12, very low ranks that are still learning the ins and outs of Infinite Warfare. It's definitely a weird contrast, but it also made doing those Venom X challenges a lot more difficult. Since then, I started working on some other challenges, and of course, the Season 2 Reloaded update came to Black Ops Cold War, which took our attention away from Infinite Warfare for a couple of weeks, but we're back, and I wanted to let y'all know what I'm currently doing to work towards that next rank. So, since the last time I recorded Infinite Warfare, I ended up getting the Raijin EMX SMG done. This is a very weird burst fire SMG that has an EMP grenade built into a launcher that you can fire, and then, of course, disable people's equipment and mini-maps and things of that nature. It wasn't too difficult to complete. I actually forgot how easy it was to complete SMGs in this game. Really, all you have to worry about is getting hipfire kills, which is something I totally forgot until I sat down and then went for it. It only took a couple of hours, and I gained a pretty massive amount of XP from that. One other thing that I realized was double XP tokens actually double the amount of XP you get from challenges. So if I'm working on Black Sky or completing a rig challenge or going through and completing some sort of equipment challenge, as long as I'm able to complete it within that game, all of the XP that I got from the challenges completed plus the XP earned from the match can then be doubled with an XP token. So because of this, a light bulb went off in my head. Hey, I have a bunch of DLC weapons that I still need to work on. And I did mention this in my last video, but just as a refresher, all of the DLC weapons, well, I really haven't done them. And that leaves me with the Stallion and the Atlas LMG. We have the Proteus Sniper that switches into a shotgun. I also have to use the Trek 50 Sniper. All of these come together, and then that's tons of XP, especially when I double them up with the tokens. So last time I did the Raijin EMX, and then I wanted to mix things up a little bit, so I started working on a secondary weapon, that being the Stallion. This is the 44 Magnum that was added pretty late into the game's life. This one is pretty difficult to use, so I'm going to be doing that in a separate episode. I kind of want to talk about that weapon in particular because I didn't realize how difficult it is to use, specifically when going for headshots. It's not the most lenient weapon in the world. Even when you have the hollow point rounds on it, it doesn't really seem to give you headshots even in a point blank situation in core game modes. Hardcore is definitely going to be the way to go, but because this game is kind of older, it's hard to find hardcore modes that are tolerable. I will say that. So because of the struggle bus I was riding with the Stallion, I decided to switch it up a bit and use the Auger. This is an LMG that's capable of being dual-wield, and I went ahead and I decided to use it for the video today, which is what you've been looking at for the past couple of minutes. The Auger itself actually shreds, man. I mean, it is amazing at close range. I love this thing even at long range. If you have the laser sights on there, there's a possibility to take enemies out that are unsuspecting, especially now, like I said, there's a big contrast between players who actually know what they're doing versus players that are still kind of learning the ins and outs of the game. You could take those guys off guard pretty easily, and it's powerful too. You will completely melt somebody that's point blank. Using the dual-wield version of the Auger is amazing, especially for those maps that take place in super tight hallways, close quarters environments. It's going to be great for taking out multiple enemies at once. You could just completely sweep them off their feet. And also, we have to remember, the Auger has an interesting rate of fire, as you will gain speed depending on how long you sustain your fire. So the longer you spray, the faster those bullets are going to come flying out of the barrel. Because of how the rate of fire works, it can actually put you in some pretty precarious situations, especially when you come face to face with an enemy, especially when you just have a single auger. Thankfully, there is a variant called Prime that kind of deletes the idea of ramping up the speed. You get maximum fire rate right out the gate at a cost of lowering that rate of fire overall. But because of this, it allows you to take on enemies head on when you normally wouldn't be able to do that with the Auger. It's a very weird way to play, but this is one of those things that we've talked about before. Having those variants that change up the way the game plays, that is where all that pay-to-win conversation comes into play. The good news is, and I say it's good news because that means extra XP for the grind, I still have plenty of challenges to do with these DLC weapons. So with the Auger, I'm currently working on going for those headshots. It might not seem like it based off the gameplay and, you know, not being super accurate with the dual-wield version of it, but I wanted to have some fun and I wanted to get normal kills first because the way the challenges were stacked in this game, it's a little interesting in which you have to unlock tiers of challenges to get to the next one. At first, you have to get 200 kills, and then you go to 160 headshots, and then you do all the, I guess you would say, technical challenges from there, like slide kills and things of that nature. So there's lots that needs to be done. 160 headshots still needs to be done with the Stallion as well, so I'm not looking forward to that. But yeah, I pretty much just wanted to give you guys this update here to let you all know what the heck's going on with the Infinite Warfare series. I know that there are plenty of you out there still kind of cheering me on, even though there are still plenty of people out there saying, who the hell cares? In my eyes, it's just one of those things that I feel like I needed to do and I needed to come back and complete it. And with these lulls that we have in between updates happening in Warzone and Black Ops Cold War, it gives me that opportunity to come back and, of course, create content about it using weapons that I didn't have a chance to use back when the game was live. And also, I feel like I need to say sorry to the developers. At the time when this game was out, I was extremely hard on it. I mean, maybe I wasn't as hard on it as other people. I still played the game and I enjoyed myself, but I didn't enjoy it nearly as much as any other Call of Duty game I had played, and that really did rub off on my content. And yeah, I should probably apologize to you guys too, because I really didn't give it a fighting chance. And I think many people look back on these games and they say to themselves, yeah, you know what? It wasn't as bad as I thought it was at the time, because they look at what we have currently and then they say, you know what? Those games that I thought sucked, yeah, they didn't really suck all that bad compared to what we have now. So I've seen that time and time again. But one thing that I did want to mention for the next episode, I am actually going to try something that I've never done before. Since this game is old and technically it's not being supported anymore and it's not being updated anymore and nobody's getting banned anymore. By the way, I found somebody under the map today. I thought that was weird. Long story short, I'm going to attempt to reach out to somebody at Activision or at Infinity Ward or somebody from that team, and I'm going to see if I can get them to turn on double XP. I think that it's totally acceptable for when a game goes away for them to fully flip on the double XP counter at all times with a game that is no longer going to receive updates. I think that that would be awesome and beneficial to those players that are just hopping in for the first time. It lets them unlock things a little bit easier. Plus, of course, with double XP, it'll let me rank up a little bit easier too, and we'll be able to do that journey just a bit faster. Not to say that I wouldn't enjoy it anyway, but I think that it would be a cool thing to happen if I could get double XP turned on indefinitely for Infinite Warfare. Even if they did it silently, I wouldn't even care. Turn on the double XP. Let's get it going. I'm gonna reach out to some people. Don't know if it's possible. Don't know if I'm even gonna break through to anybody, but I will keep you all posted on that front if I hear anything back. If I don't, which I probably won't, yeah. Or maybe one day double XP will just mysteriously turn on. That could definitely be a thing that happens. I'm keeping my fingers crossed. Anyway, thank you all so much for watching this video and this update on my road to 30. If you guys enjoyed, drop a like on it. Subscribe for more videos coming each and every day. And if you haven't yet, don't forget to ring that bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. Alrighty, folks, I will catch you on the next one.
Peace.